Good morning, everybody. My name is Luca Anconi, and I'm responsible for the organization and planning of the first year chemistry teaching. It is my pleasure to welcome you all to university and especially to this introductory talk about the first year chemistry courses. To be honest, in the past I used to give a much more, let's say, interactive and catchy introductory talks, but as you all are aware of, that's the new normal, and we all have to get used to it. We are going to face an unusual academic year, extraordinary in some ways, and unfortunately this will result in very limited face-to-face interaction between you and your lecturers. Anyway, that's where we are lying at the moment, so today I'm going to give you just some basic information about the first year chemistry courses. More detailed information will be available in due course, especially on Blackboard, the teaching and learning platform we use for pretty much everything. So let me just share with you my presentation. Here we go. Okay, so first question. What course are you enrolled in? Now, depending on your course instance, you will be enrolled in different courses. For example, if you are a biopharmaceutical chemistry student or a general science undenominated student, you will be enrolled in CH101 course, and I'm the coordinator of this course. And you will have lectures and practicals over both semesters 1 and 2. If you have these course instances, then you are enrolled in CH120, and the coordinator is Dr. Patrick O'Leary. And lectures will be delivered over both semesters, but the practicals will be in semester 1 for those of you who are 1MR1 students, and in semester 2 for 1BO1 and 0MB3. And if you have these course instances, then you will be enrolled in the CH130. The coordinator is still Dr. O'Leary, and in this case you will have lectures and practicals over both semesters. There are two additional courses. So CH140 for students having these course instances. And in this case, students will have lectures and practicals only in semester 1. And analogously for students who are actually enrolled in the CP102 course. In both cases, the coordinator is Professor Donald Leach. Now, in the past, these courses were separated, so they had different timetables, different lectures. But this year, exceptionally, all first-year chemistry modules will follow pretty much the same syllabus and delivery program, with some minor exceptions. Now, when are you starting? All first-year chemistry modules will start the same day. Now, given that we cannot accommodate you all in the same lecture theater due to the restrictions imposed to a limited spread of COVID-19, all lectures and tutorials will be pre-recorded and uploaded on Blackboard. And we will do our best to upload these lectures according to a well-defined timetable. For the practicals, the situation is different. First of all, you will be notified at some point once you have registered by the college the day of practicals and allocated a bench number. Now, in the past, all practicals were, of course, in the lab, but again, due to the current restrictions, only 50% of practicals will be in the laboratory, and the remaining 50% will be virtual laboratories. That is, you will be able to carry out these practicals remotely at home. It's important that you have a good connection and a computer. Now, to enter the labs, you must bring your own laboratory coat, safety glasses, and face mask or visor. Remember that given the current situation, face coverings must be worn at all times in the lab. And you have to bring your own lab coat and goggles. We cannot lend you some because of the restrictions. Now, more details about the particles. For CH11 and CH30, there will be eight actual particles in person in the lab and eight virtual particles. So, in each semester, you will have four particle labs in the laboratory. And four virtual labs, and these will alternate every week. Same situation for semester. If you are enrolled in CH120, the particles will run in the same way as a CH11, apart from the fact that students with one MR1 course instance will do the particles in semester one, and the other students will do the particles in semester two. For CH140, there will be only virtual laboratory experiments in semester one. And for CP102 students, it will be the same schedule of CH101, but only in semester one. Now, this is the timetable for semester one. Here on the top, there is the schedule of the lectures, as you can see. You will start on the 28th of September. There will be usually three lectures per week and one tutorial per week. So the first block of the will be mine. I will teach basic concepts of chemistry, and then Professor Paul Murphy will deliver lectures on chemical reactions and finally on bonding and molecular structure. Again, these times are indicative, and we will do our best to upload the pre-recorded lectures and tutorials during these time slots. For the particles, the situation is a bit more complicated. As you can see, particles officially start on the week beginning with Monday, 26th of October. But given that this Monday is a bank holiday, a student assigned to the Monday labs will anticipate once off to the previous Friday. Now, why there are two different colors? Because in semester one, you will be split in two groups. Let's say the violet group and the orange group. For example, on week five, students in the violet group will do the particle one in the lab, and students in orange group will do the virtual practical two. The following week, it will be the other way around. So, students in the orange group will do the actual practical one, and students in the violet group will do the virtual practical two, and so on for the rest of the semester. Now, in semester two, the situation is a bit more complicated when we take into account the practicals, because there will be more students doing the first year chemistry practicals. So there will be sessions also during the morning, but the principle is the same. One week you're doing the actual practical, the following week the virtual practical, and the other way around. The teaching follows the same schedule of semester one. So you will start with Dr. O'Leary with organic chemistry, followed by Dr. Cheung with physical chemistry, and finally, again, myself with inorganic chemistry. Now, what about the assessment? There are two components, the written examination and the continuous assessment. Until last year, there were two written examinations, one at the end of semester one and one at the end of semester two. Unfortunately, this year, we cannot do the written examination at the end of semester one because of the current restrictions. So there will be only one written examination at the end of semester two, and this is worth 30%. Meaning that the continuous assessment will overall account for the remaining 70%. What is this continuous assessment? This includes the laboratory work and the reports, so overall accounting for the 30% of the final mark. Online tests only in semester one, again accounting for 30%, and weekly online homework accounting for 10% overall. Just remember that there is a very important college rule, that is, the mark in the continuous assessment component must be at least 5%. If in the overall continuous assessment you don't get at least 35%, you are deemed incomplete and you cannot sit the written examination. So pay attention to this, because this is an important rule. Now, I guess you have a lot of questions. Here I'm trying to answer some of your more common questions. The first one, which is usually in the top list of questions, is this one. Is the chemistry course at university level different from that in high school? Absolutely yes, because we are going to deal with pretty much the same topics, but with a very different approach. And this is due to the fact that we are going faster through the various topics, and you will not be spoon-fed, let's say, like you were in high school. We will provide help, we will deliver lectures and tutorials and labs, but you have to spend an appropriate amount of time in self-studying, self-learning. Another important point, do you need to have taken chemistry in high school to pass the chemistry course at university? Absolutely not. This is a foundations course. So we start from scratch, from the ABC of chemistry. But again, remember that everything is faster and you have to keep up with all the information, lectures, and so on. Where can you get all the information about the course? On Blackboard. You will have to learn how to use Blackboard, because all the information will be there and will be uploaded in a timely manner in advance. For example, the lecture notes will be uploaded before uploading the pre-recorded lecture, so you can have an idea of what the pre-recorded lectures will deal with. How will the module be assessed? I've already given you some information, but detailed information will be uploaded on Blackboard soon, and I will also give more details during my first lecture. What about the attendance? Attendance is compulsory, but if you're not attending, there is nothing we can do. This being said, we will monitor the attendance to Blackboard Collaborate. This is the virtual classroom where you will find all the pre-recorded lectures, and there is a way in which we can monitor your attendance. What about the recommended textbook? You are strongly encouraged to buy the textbook, because even if usually our slides are self-explanatory, but we use the reference textbook as actually a reference for the whole course. And you can find it in the library. You can buy the new second-hand e-book. So there are many also cheap options. So if you have problems or you want to ask us questions, do we have office hours for individual meetings? I cannot speak for the other lecturers, but as far as I'm concerned, I don't have official office hours for meetings. But you can always drop me a line and this email, and I can arrange an appointment with you. Of course, a virtual appointment. Now, as I anticipated, chemistry at the university is more difficult than chemistry at high school, and you might at some point struggle a bit to keep up with the course material. Now, remember that there are additional resources, online resources, in these links, but also we have our postgraduate students that are registered to give chemistry grants. And if you're really struggling for reasons other than chemistry itself, so for personal reasons, personal problems, remember that there is always the counseling service of the university. Now, I should be done, but I'm taking 2 more minutes just to give you an opportunity to see what's next. Now, imagine that you are undenominated BS student, you're fascinated by chemistry, and you want to continue to get a chemistry degree. Now, in year one, you should have taken chemistry, physics, mathematics, and biology. In year two, you have different options, of course, a chemistry, and you can choose between topics in other fields. In year three, you must take at least 50% chemistry courses, and the remaining courses can be chosen from biochemistry. And in year four is definitely only just to let you know that 3 years ago we started with this new medicinal chemistry pathway. It starts from year two. There are usually 20 places available, and there are entry requirements. So if you're really interested in medicinal chemistry, you can apply for this course from year two, but again, there are limited places. So basically, the higher your marks, the greater the chance that you can actually enter this pathway. So I would say that I'm done with my presentation, and I think that's all for the moment. Again, it's a pity you won't be able to enjoy the full college experience this year, but hopefully we will get back to normal next year. So, again, welcome aboard. I wish you the very best of luck for this new experience of yours. Take care and see you soon, at least virtually. See you guys.